So if you can accept that brilliant concept, and then you add to it your understanding that here in this sifting through the variety of your life experience, you're constantly knowing what you want. Preferences are born within you all day, every day. You can't have a conversation with anyone. You can't eat a meal. You can't look around. You can't cease preferring. You can't cease preferring improvement. You can't cease preferring more than what is, because your eternal orientation is this never-ending expansion. When you accept that you are eternal, that means you've accepted that you are forever. It means that, and that must mean that you have accepted that you are expanding, because you can't stand still. Nothing does. So when you couple our brilliant analogy of looking forward rather than down through the floorboards of your car, and you begin to take this broad view of this eternal being that you are, then if you can incorporate this understanding to acknowledge that what is always, only, ever the bouncing off place for more. But it's not just that. It's that all of the joy and all of the exhilaration is looking toward what's coming. Now, it's really, 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 really fun when you get oriented and pointed in the direction of what you've become. And we want to tell you why. Because this larger part of you who remains non-physically focused is holding steadily the vibrations that you have been incrementally providing. In other words, the larger part of you remains non-physically focused while this part that you know as you is here. But this important part that you know is here as you in this personality, sifting through the contrast, knowing what you don't want, knowing what you do want, knowing what you don't want, knowing what you do want. If you don't want it a little, you'd want it a little. If you really don't want it, you really want it. In other words, this contrast serving all of you, all of us perfectly. So these desires are moving forward, and the larger part of you is becoming the vibrational essence of that desire, and then projecting that new knowledge, that new understanding, that new, here's the word, beingness, right back to you. Which means when you want it, source is it and reflects it to you. That's what that instant manifestation is that you've been talking about. You want it, source is it, reflects it back to you. But the question is, when source is reflecting it back to you, where are you? Where are you? And you say, well, I'm doing my part, Abraham. I'm doing the part that I think I was sent here to do. I'm sifting through the contrast. And whoop-de-doo, I launched a rocket and you rode it, but I'm still justifying the rocket. I'm still explaining to everyone why I want that, because I hate this. And we say, that's that thing you do. You get hung up on the contrast. You don't use the contrast in quite the way you intended. You intended to know what you want and then go with the flow of it. And when you go with the flow of what you want, so that you are vibrationally up to speed with the source within you, now as source reflects back through you, you're right there in the perfect vibrational stance to receive the fullness of what you have asked for. And now you have instant manifestation. So what do we mean by an instant manifestation? We mean you have instantly adjusted your vibration upward to allow the complete incorporation into what you've asked for, and now your point of attraction matches your desire. And what happens when your point of attraction matches your desire? Everything that comes to you must reflect that vibrational essence. It's law. It has to be. And if it isn't happening that way, it's because of what we just demonstrated to you. You're hung up on explaining why you want that, but you're not a match to the that that you want. You're a match to the why you don't want the thing that caused you to launch the thing that you want. That was really good. You're not a match to the what you want. You're a match to the reason that you wanted it. But the reason that you want it is because you don't have it. And when you're a match to the reason that you don't have it, you're a match to the absence of it. And when you're a match to the absence of it, you can't have it. And that's why you don't feel good. And that's why you don't allow the fullness of who you are, who has it and is it and bees it, to be right there with you now. You've got it pinched off because you're a match to the absence of it and to the instead of to the having of it. Couldn't be clearer, could it? Couldn't be clearer. Doesn't that just make perfect sense to you? Aren't you really wanting to be a vibrational match to what you're wanting? So then, does it not occur to you, if this is true, and it is, everything that you or ever anyone has ever wanted or ever will want, you want it because you believe you will feel better in the having of it, then must it not be true that if you are able to feel good in the not having of it, that then it must come? In other words, if it's true that everything you want is because you want to feel good, then isn't the true manifestation that you're reaching for, isn't the manifestation that you're looking for the emotional response to the thing you're trying to create? Isn't it? Now, some of you are afraid to say yes to that because you think we're going to then announce to you, good, then no longer want anything. Just be the spiritual beings that you are. And yeah, that's pretty much what we're saying. When you give up the intoxication of the manifestation and you let the conjuring of the emotion be the manifestation that you're looking for, then you have accomplished instant manifestation. And then you say, yeah, but what about the car? What about the lover? What about the pile of money? What about the physical conditions? What about? And we say, it has to come. That all must come. That all must come. But if you make your emotion conditional upon it coming, it can't come if your emotion is tied to the absence of it. So how do you make your emotion tied to something that you don't have? That's the kicker, isn't it? How do I make my emotion be a response to something that isn't yet? And we say, because you're smart. You have the ability to do that. Sometimes you have to get more general. In other words, sometimes you have to remind yourself, well, I believe in law of attraction. It's proven itself to me over and over again. I believe in my ability to focus. I've showed myself that on many occasions. I trust in the universal laws. I've practiced it enough to know. I have enough evidence. I get it that when I'm in a bad mood, things don't go well for me. And when I'm in a good mood, things go better for me. I get it that my mood affects things. And since I've been paying attention to that, I really get that. So even though I am the first to admit that I cannot yet very well control my mood, I am willing to admit that my mood does affect what comes next. Well, that's a general statement, and it's a very powerful first step, isn't it? So when we ask you, and we're going to do it here just because we want to, why do you want what you want? Why do you want what you want? What do you want? What do you want? What do you want? If you meet someone on the street and they say, hello, what do you want? What do you tell them? Well, now we've coached you into the perfect answer. But what kind of things do you tell normal people? Well, I want a better job. And I want my body to look better or feel better. Or I want more money. I want more freedom. I want to do more fun things. I want to have the freedom to travel. I want a better living environment. And of course you do say, I want to be happy. But most of the time when you're thinking of manifestations, you're thinking of stuff, aren't you? Or conditions, aren't you? You're thinking of something other than your emotion over which you have complete and immediate control. And we just want to convey to you that if you can leave this gathering accepting personally for yourself that what you really are wanting to be the creator of is the emotion which you have the ability to conjure no matter where you are within 10 minutes, we're not kidding you. And that if you will, in fact, deliberately conjure the good feeling emotion within 10 minutes, whenever anything is out of whack for you, that you will begin to show yourself the power of your point of attraction. And we want to put this to you in a stronger way than we ever have. We want you to show yourself the power of our point of attraction. Our point of attraction. Because you're not in this alone. You weren't alone when you came, and you're not alone now. And you're not alone when you're moving through the contrast, and we're not talking about the other billions of people that you're interacting with or the circumstances and events that are around you. We're talking about the fullness of source energy who is present within you now, who has a powerful point of attraction.